Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. We know services are one of the fundamental blocks of every Angular application, and we also know that we need to provide the service to use it in our application. There are different ways of providing services. In earlier days, we used to provide the service in the providers array of the root module. But nowadays, when we create a service using CLI, it automatically adds the @injectable decorator and provide the service in root. There is no big difference between providing the service in providers array of the root module and using @injectable decorator to provide it in root. When we provide it using @injectable decorator, Angular can optimize removing the service if it turns out not to be used after all. And we can also provide the service in component instead of module. In this video, I'm going to explain the impact of providing service in module and in component. Let's start. I have created an Angular application in which I have created two components, header and home, and two modules, user and product. In user module, I have two components. First user and second user. And in product module, I have two components, first product and second product. In app routing module, for path home, I'm showing home component. And for path user, I'm lazy loading the user module. And for path product, I'm lazy loading the product module. And in user module for path first, I'm showing the first user component. And for path second, I'm showing the second user component. Similarly, in product module, I'm showing the first product component for path first, and second product component for path second. In app component, I'm having the app header and the router outlet. And in header component, I have all the links and I am routing to the respective pages. I have also created a service in which I have a count which is initialized to 5. And I have two functions, one to increase the count and another one to decrease. If you see in all components, I have the same code. I have a title, and then I have a count and two buttons to increase and decrease the count. In the TypeScript component, in onInit, I'm getting the count from shared service and assigning to the count. In increase function, I'm calling the increase count function in shared service and then getting that count and assigning to this count. In decrease function, I'm doing the same but using the decrease count function in shared service. This is my code setup. Let me show you the preview. So we can navigate between the components and we can see the only thing changing is the title. Now let's get into the concept. As you see, I have created this service using CLI, and so it is provided in root using the @injectable decorator. Let me go to the home page, and I am increasing this count. Now it is 7. If I go to the first user, we can see the updated count. Here let me decrease and moving to second user. We can see the updated count is retained. Let me increase it again and move to first product. Here also we can see the count is retained. Let me decrease and move to the second product. And we can see the latest count. This is because when we provide the service in root, there will be only one instance of the service created. It is called singleton. Instead of providing the service using @injectable decorator, if I provide the service in providers array of root module, we will get the same effect. Let's confirm that. Okay, now I am going to provide the service in the user module. As I have also provided in the root module, all the components in the user module will have a separate instance of this service and the rest of the components will have another instance. So we are having two instances of service now. And so if I increase the count in the home component and move to first user, we can see the first user is still having the initial count 5. Even second user is having the same. But if I move to first product, we can see the updated count. And if I increase further in first product, we can see it is increased in second product and home as well. But user is still holding the original value. If I change in first user, we can see it is getting changed in second user, but not in the product and home. That means user module and its components are having one instance and rest of the modules and their components are having separate instance. If I provide it separately in product module, product will also have a separate instance. Instead, let me provide the service in first product component, so that we can see what will happen when we provide in component level. Now let me increase the count in home to 10. In user, we can see it is still having the original count because we have provided in user module. But if I go to first product, we can see that is also holding the original value, because as we have provided in component level, this component will have a separate instance. If I go to second product, we can see the updated count, because second product is still using the instance from root module. I hope you understand the difference between providing the service in root module, separate module, and in component level. Now let me ask you a question. Let me remove all the providers I added, even in the root module. Now we will get the null injector error. The question is, what will happen if I provide the service in app component instead of app module? This will work like providing in the app module. Let's confirm that first. Okay. This is because when we provide the service in a component, not only that component, its children component will also have the same instance. As we are providing in the app component, that means the root component, all the components will have the same instance. That is why it is behaving like this. Hope you understood and you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.